Where would it have gone if it didn't?
No, we're not live.
You think we're live? Because it doesn't show up on my thing.
We'll see.
Hey everybody, it's Cinnamon Cooney, your Art Sherpa, and theoretically on Facebook today, I'm going to do an unboxing and also show you how to draw in two ways the Steampunk Girl for tomorrow's lesson. Because there was actually a specific request saying, hey, are you going to show us how to draw this in? And I just thought, I can show you how to draw it in. I can do that for sure. And so I'm going to do that today. Can you see?
It's all good. We're good. I see
you're
people.
You good? I don't see me.
Well, you know, it's one of those funny things where...
I see you don't see me anywhere.
It's out there. I see it. And there's already 60, 70 people here
joining
us.
Okay, well, I can't... Apparently, it doesn't show me anymore.
It doesn't want to show you anymore.
All right. So you're going to have to do comments.
I'm going to do comments with you here in a second.
I'm so glad somebody can see me. Oh, you know what? How did you do the settings? Did you do it public or private?
I think I did it public.
Okay. Well, we'll find out.
It says peak live people are here. This is one... I don't know.
Oh,
I don't know
sweetie.
What I'm doing. You know,
I don't
think
know
it's,
either.
I think it's working.
You see people.
I see people. I see people. I see a dashboard which says that there are people here.
Okay. Well, generally the dashboard doesn't lie to us.
No, it doesn't. So you keep
for
going.
For some reason, I just can't see events, I guess.
Yeah.
All right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sketch in my girl here. And the first one I'm going to do is very similar to the one that you see on this canvas. She's got a traditional...
Oh, hold on.
She's got kind of a traditional little steampunk line and everything, and so I'm going to show you how I do her in. But today I'm also going to show you a full-figured goddess as well, so that everybody can feel like they're represented in their canvas the way they'd most ideally like to be represented. And I'll make sure that those end up being traceables that you guys can get to on TheArtSherpa.com. All right, so the first thing whenever I'm doing these traceables, whenever I'm creating these things, I will put in the head, and that's just going to be this fun little egg shape. And it tells me a lot about everything else that I'm going to do, right? And I know, you know, that she's got kind of a flirty little curve figure, which I'll give myself a little gesture to be like, hey, I got to go that way. I like to bring down a little neck. I curve that in. And then when I'm starting... trying to think about how I'm going to sketch my figure in. I know I've got to have a spot. It's also about a head big for her chest, and I need room for lungs, right? You got to have some lungs in there. Off each side, I'm going to need to have shoulders. So I generally kind of sketch in those little shapes. And then I know I'm going to need another little head here. That's, you know, the lower part of her torso. And when I have those things in, that lets me start refining my idea a little bit. And what I like to think about is the types of lines that I'm looking to have and how those lines flow and how I might take those lines and make them a little more interesting. I'm going to curve in this rib cage and curve down. I know she's corseted, so I'm going to want to pull that back out.
Mm-hmm.
And I like to... match this curve over here, curving in, and this is going to be a pretty slender waist because maybe she's been waist training. seriously, you'd have to.
I found our chat and I have everybody up in here.
You do?
I do. We have a full room here tonight.
So I'm gonna pull the corset in like this, and across the back where I know that is. Now on the dress. And this is going to be an important thing when you get the traceable. And I'll demo this tomorrow when I put it in. You're going to just take this off. It's a very full dress. It's just going to come off like this. So just trying to pull that slight figure there. Just make sure I've got that. Now, this arm here is holding a wine glass.
Mm.
Right? So one of the things that if you think if there's a waist here, this is a fulcrum,
mm-hmm.
right? So you know that whatever kind of shoulder you have, right, whether you're doing a very fantasy or a chibi or whatever,
mm-hmm.
chibi being a very short Asian style animation, that your elbows are generally going to bend or be placed somewhere at the waistline. So even as I put in this arm, I am thinking about that. You can see I kind of imply that. But I'll really talk about it over here a bit on the arm holding the wine glass. So, you know, apparently she's pretty tough, so she's got good shoulders. Decision that I made. I make these little decisions. I tell myself background stories about the girls. So I can see the back of her arm here, and I know I've got a forearm coming forward.
Everybody here has a lot of ideas about dresses and haircuts and styles. And Kim was already talking about wanting to do gears on the dress.
Take it as far as you can, right? That would be my advice. I'm going to pull the thumb out. In her hand, which is holding the wine glass, you know, might come out here. So a lot of the fingers aren't showing.
Mm-hmm.
So I tend to sort of disappear them. And then I know I've got the wine stem coming down here. So I'll put the bowl.
Oh, wow.
Placed in her hand. Drop it with an ellipse. And then I'm going to have a nice ellipse down here. I want to have that where I like it. Then I can kind of work out the stem. And then I know I like to, I'll tell myself like, oh, maybe this is splashing. So it'll come up like that. On her head then, I'm going to come in and start working her head. Right? So one of the things is I like a chignon.
What's that?
It's a French bun, French twist.
Oh, yeah.
So how I do that is I draw a little swirl up here and then I mark where I'm going to have that tucked hair down to a tapered line. I'm going to give her a good head. Just means like a nice symmetrical head that doesn't have a strange or unusual flat part. But I'm going to give her a couple little ears tucked off. And then I realized that I would want a hat, a steampunk hat. So there's the lips. This is a fascinator.
A fascinator?
Mm-hmm. It means it's these small little hat, little pieces on top of the head.
Fascinator.
It's fascinating to do a fascinator. And that way I have that there when I'm going to draw her in. And then, you know, I have my neck there. I'll do a poof sleeve. Comes into a tight arm here. Poof sleeve. Comes into a tight arm here. And this is all, and I'm really going to end up really showing where this seam and this seam come together.
Mm-hmm.
And then this ends up being a glove.
Oh, nice.
Right? And of course, it blocks some of the wine stem. And generally, when I'm doing traceables, if you guys are trying to do these for yourselves at home, once I have a sketch in that I like, what I like to do is then place it underneath here. And that allows me to do clean work.
Gotcha.
So I can keep all the things that I like when I was making decisions and get rid of anything that I'm not a huge fan of.
You sharpen your pencil there?
Yeah, I like working a sharp pencil. Now, let's say, though, that I really, really wanted her to be more rounded and more full-figured. It's not just about making people bigger because, you know, we're not like balloons. We didn't get inflated. We just enjoy cake. It's not air, it's cake. It's cookies. It's our favorite things. So, but we're still ourselves, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you don't want to sit there and take away that truth, right?
Oh, yeah.
Right, so we're going to take her into Bridget Jones 1 territory. And I did make the head a smidge bit bigger. Not a lot, just a smidge. Because, strangely enough, that actually is a thing. I'm going to curve our neck just a smidge. But this is something you don't want to overdo on the neck because it can get uncomplimentary and probably is unlikely. Right? And I'm going to work the figure here before I put in the arms. And I'm still going to want... She's still in waist training. She still has a corset going.
Mm-hmm.
But her arms are going to change a lot. Enough so I'm probably going to have to pull what's underneath here to change out that line.
Ah, gotcha.
And I'm raising up this part for the dress. See? I'm going to raise that up, that part for the dress.
Gotcha.
Now I'll pull the girl out here so I can work the rest of my girl so she can be her utterly fabulous self. is going to be her utterly fabulous self.
Now, lots of people are complimenting your hairpiece. They just love it.
Thank you. So, same thing. She has shoulders, right?
Mm-hmm.
She didn't lose shoulders. Nope. So, now there are things that I'm going to not always necessarily tell in my story.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to tell the parts of the story that I like. And so I'm going to bring this off here. Same thing. See, already clearly she's not, you know. Now, the arm actually here on the back changes a little bit. See?
Mm-hmm.
But we still have to have the elbow here. And then I'm going to move this out a little from the body than maybe I might have.
Okay. Oh, yeah. That's very nice.
And that same thing. We're just making some different lines. And you can always come in and say, no, I want the neck to come in, or I want, you know, this to happen here. Definitely keep the corset there.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And you're going to work the hand.
Now, are you going to make this traceable available as well?
Yep.
Oh, good. That'll make it easier for everybody.
If you're not into drawing,
yeah,
don't worry about it. We're going to make this traceable available as well. Okay? Little trick here. If you're going to do a bigger girl,
mm-hmm.
for all of us bigger girls out there, give the girl a bigger glass. Do not sit there and give her, give her a teeny tiny glass in her hand. Give her something worth drinking. Okay? Give her something worth drinking. Tomorrow, so you can see I've made that a little bit bigger, haven't I?
Oh, yeah.
Right? He'll be like, oh, no, my girl went and got a real goblet.
Mm-hmm.
She doesn't need that. She's not doing the other thing. She said no. She's like, somebody needs to give me an actual glass of wine here. I got in this dress. I'm here with my friends. I need this actual glass of wine. That doesn't mean it can't have the same little splash that's happening. The other thing that you're going to really want to have is make sure you kind of really tell about that elbow right here. And this part of the arm will be a little more covered by this part of the arm.
Mm-hmm.
She's still going to have her little puff sleeves. She hasn't given up on fashion. No siree, Bob. They're still going on, right? Got her little neck. And she's still going to be wearing her awesome hat. Don't be kidding yourself.
Her...
Fascinator.
Fascinator.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it's called.
So, you know, hit your lips for the hat. Definitely, no, give her a hat. And she's going to be fabulous no matter whether she's a size 4 dress or a size 14 dress, because women of every age and every size are awesome.
Mm-hmm.
So have that going on there. See how we haven't lost our drawing at all? We haven't lost our story.
Not at all.
It hasn't changed in any way. Just, and then if you look at, I have quests for skin color and hair color. You can really customize any of these girl paintings to be anybody you love in your life. They can be you in your life. You can tell all these stories. And really, art is about telling your own story. So it's like wonderful when you're telling the story with me and you get exactly my result. But it's really special when you guys start telling your own personal stories in the paintings.
Yeah, everybody's really... Can you hold up those two versions there for us so we can see them side by side? They really love that you've got both versions there for them. And I'm going to make sure that...
So there's this one. See, they could be best friends, couldn't they?
Oh, yeah, let me go back over here.
They did matching things. Notice about the glass.
Oh, here, go with the other camera. If you lean the other way, they can see. I've got the other camera adjusted. Your main one.
Okay.
See? Perfect.
So notice about the glass. Yeah. The glass is...
Yep.
Right? You know, glasses slightly. And I'll probably, like, you know, work her a little bit. I might pull her waist or long,
now,
you know.
When can they paint this?
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Tomorrow at noon.
At noon.
Mm-hmm. Gonna.
I better get to sleep in that.
So what's going to happen is, no, you have work to do. Tomorrow before the lesson, this video is going to go up. That's going to show you how to do this background, because this background has a lot of layers.
Where can we find out more information?
About the background?
Like at TheArtSherpa.com?
TheArtSherpa.com.
Okay. It's a trick question.
You know, and interesting special materials you're going to want is this iridescent bright gold fine, and then, of course, the craft sea sponge.
Sea sponge.
So
noon central time.
Yeah, noon central time. So this will be up first, so you guys can have this all in before we ever go live.
That's assuming I go to sleep tonight.
Assuming you go to sleep tonight or don't get up early in the morning. Then we're going to meet up and we're going to take our traceable, unless you've already freehanded it in, because some of you are ready to just freehand this in.
Yep.
And we're going to put her on the canvas.
Yes.
In whatever version we want. And then we're going to paint her in together. And then we're all done. We'll make sure that the rest of the gold patina is like spot on perfect.
Ooh. So we're going to meet up tomorrow with it, with the background done and it all traced in, so that we can just go.
And we're into it. And that way also, so that you can just have the background if you just want the background. You could also do the other steampunk background that we just did with the bokeh Edison bulbs.
Ooh, the yeah, Eureka, that's right.
Would also look really good with her. And I want you guys to start thinking about these as fashion separates. Sometimes that these backgrounds and these girls, they mix and match.
Yeah.
And you can change them up.
Now, there's been a lot of folks out here who've been just saying, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. And Michelle just sent you a big thank you. She was in the ER last week and stuck there for a bunch of testing. Mm-hmm. And really was she saw a bunch of your videos and got through and really appreciated it. And
I hope you're out and you're okay and you're healthy and you're all right now.
Yeah. Yes. You see, she does seem to be out. And, you know, I have to say thank you to all the Sherpettes that have been out here. Michelle, Roxanne, Cheryl, Ashley, Amy, Jenny. And I see Jane Wood. Oh, and lots of our Sherpettes from over on YouTube have joined us tonight. So Cinnamon's going to see if she can find her chat there.
I'm just going to see if it like even tells me. Yeah. Oh, well, and now it says I'm live.
And a
now
shout out to Janine and Kate. So there, I see them out there. Thank you, guys.
It acknowledges me now.
Yeah. And
I see Stephanie.
And of course, Lisa's out there wrangling me, making sure.
Phoenix Fire, hi.
So they
and Josie Rafter.
Oh, there's a bunch of
Josie Rafter and four others just shared my video. Thank you, sharing is caring.
Yes.
Just spread it all over Facebook. I mean, really, now, given all the craziness that's on Facebook, and I'm not saying oyster opening is not fantastic, because frankly, oyster opening. I'm actually unsure. So I never know how I feel about it for the oyster.
Are you going to be doing another steampunk with gears? Rebecca would like to know.
Another steampunk?
Will you be doing another steampunk with gears? Rebecca would like to know.
Yes.
You have more steampunk coming.
I have to. You know what, guys? I was going to show you a cool thing with stencils. And I don't know if y'all have noticed, there's a shortage of steampunk stencils out there.
There is.
Which means I have to make steampunk stencils. And then I'm going to have to give you the stuff to make steampunk stencils, which means I'm going to have to make a whole nother video that has steampunk stencils. Or I can do key stencils, which were actually in stock where I was.
Yes.
But they were just like not. It was crazy. But no, we're definitely going to do some more steampunk stuff, because I think that these are really cool art skills, and just being able to do these backgrounds and stuff are kind of fun.
They were also saying congratulations on your brush deal. That's been, of course, a big deal.
Do you guys want to see something cool in relationship with the brush deal? Because this has been happening in the background, but I couldn't share it with y'all. I get these boxes from Silver Brush Company.
Oh, yes. Yeah, you're hoping to be able to share some of these. You have one there with you?
Yeah, I have a box with me. It just came today. Very, very late, but it came. So in this box is the book, which I'm probably going to have to memorize.
You should zoom out a little bit up top.
Okay, can I?
You just, yeah.
I don't know how to, which way?
There you go, right there.
There, okay.
A little bit in.
Look at this. This tells me about the things.
There's a lot of things in there.
The things.
All the brushes.
So I've been testing. You guys might recognize some of these things.
Mm-hmm.
I have been testing things and saying, how do I like them for acrylic paint? A lot of these, some of these are some of the best watercolor brushes in the world. They're some of the best oil brushes in the world. They're some of the best acrylic brushes in the world. I mean, a lot of these brushes are National Gallery portrait artists paint with these brushes.
Yeah.
So I really cannot tell you. This is a huge deal to me. So here's the fabulous catalog that I have to now. I had a job as a waitress when I was 18, and I had to learn the drink catalog, and I don't really drink, so I was just really bad at it. Like, Like, I couldn't upsell alcohol to save my life. I did not keep that job. Nope. Hi, Dawn. How are you doing? And Liana? Am I doing another heart mail episode? Yeah, I have a pile of heart mail that we want to do.
What's in the box?
What's in the box? Okay. Let's see what's in the box. The boxes are always exciting. Oh, and then here's more. That I can't show you all that.
Stuff.
That's private information. I don't know. Ooh la la, brushes. That's right, Julie. And Karen says, thank you. All right. So there. This is a box of, ooh. Oh. Oh my. Oh my. Oh my. Oh my.
What do you have there?
Everything. I have everything you could ever want.
Ooh, she sent you some nice new samples.
Right?
You're going to be testing out a whole bunch of stuff there.
So, they were supposed to be a triangle brush, right?
Maybe.
I don't know. I have to look at the invoice.
The invoice.
I'm just going to open what I have.
We're going to open and show us what you got there.
And there's nothing.
Oh, there's one right there. There's a little, see down there towards the bottom?
What?
The smaller one on the left-hand side?
There it is! Okay. So, I've been hearing about this brush. I see green handles, says Bethany, and Bethany's right. That means either ruby satin silvers or in general, the Grand Prix.
Grand Prix with the copper ferrules.
With the copper ferrules. I'm insane about the Grand Prix as well. These are amazing.
It's a giant filbert.
Brushes. Just, yeah. Well, because we have something coming up where filberts are useful.
Oh, that's right.
Let's see this triangle brush, though, that I'm hearing about it.
It looks like a little.
The silver varnish brush is the best brush I've ever used. Thank you for the recommendation. It's crazy good, right?
Yeah.
Look at this cool brush. It's shaped as a triangle. It's a triangle shape. I'm going to have to test it now, is what's happening. I'm going to get the sizing out of it and feel it. This is like, I kind of just, this is really cool.
It's a triangle.
I'm freaking out right here. It's a triangle. Can y'all see how triangly it is?
You should zoom in on it.
Can I zoom in on it?
You can. Okay, hold on.
Then it went dark.
Oh, hold on. I can fix that.
Can you?
Because I go over this camera and
I've just never seen it. I've never seen this kind of brush before. I don't really need to see the edge of my hands this closely, but, you know, hold it up, please. So, can you guys see it? The shape, the cut?
Yeah.
Is that crazy? All right. So, what this little sucker is a triangle. I've never painted with one of these. I am in brush heaven, Kimberly. I am in brush heaven.
Oh, you have to zoom back out now.
Well, I don't know, but there's other brushes here.
Wait, or could zoom. Oh, that is cool.
That's interesting. Oh, this is very fascinating. Right? I've got some great filberts here. Filberts are very lovely when you're doing portrait work. We haven't done a lot of portrait work, so there hasn't been a huge need for them. But now there is. Look at this. I really like to combine a natural bristle with a synthetic bristle because they do different things and they have a different performance. Tammy, some of these will be in the Sherpa packages, yes. And some of them will be in future Sherpa packages. And then there's the brushes that I'm working with to make from scratch.
Zoom out.
Are they going to be inexpensive?
Zoom out.
All right, let me zoom out.
Too much. Okay, good. Okay. Right there.
I don't know. You're stun hands.
I don't have a zoomer
so
on
the,
that one.
The explanation. So what I'll say for this is, I hate to say my inexpensive might not be somebody else's inexpensive.
But we can't.
So what I would say is go by the brushguys.com and check out the prices there.
But what we will say is that we're trying to offer some that that go the entire gambit.
Yeah.
Of from, you know, entry level to professional level, and yeah, we're testing all of her brushes out, making sure that, you know, we're going to be able to accommodate all the price points you guys need.
Rebecca Wardy's Brink said, is Michael's going to carry? I don't know, Rebecca. Is Michael's going to carry? I mean, they could if they wanted to. I'm just saying, if you would like your local art store, big box store, local multinational chain craft store, whether you're in the U.S. or in Canada or wherever you are, overseas or in Germany, wherever it is, this is a global company. They've been around forever. They can get into your store. What I'll tell you is if you ask for it and your store asks for it, they can get it.
So the short
That's
answer.
That's what I'm going to say is they can get it. Michaels could get it. If Michaels wanted it, they could get it.
Yeah, the short answer is that
me and Jane Davenport, they could get it.
Silver has a worldwide supply network. So they can supply to worldwide art and craft stores. So
angry because we don't have them, maybe? Oh, was somebody angry?
No.
I don't know. Jane was saying something about angry because we don't have them. I hope you're not angry. They're going to be here.
They're going to be here.
They're going to be here. I promise. So. Oh, angry faces are jealous of the brushes. Oh. It could be. It could just also be somebody does not have love.
Or misbuttoned.
Or misbuttoned.
I think they were misbuttoned because they all disappeared.
No, they're still going.
Oh.
They're still having their little... They're making sure we know they feel that way. Well, you know.
That happens.
Still engagement. Thank you for the interaction. Would you like to have all those, please? I'd like to pay in advance. These are really going to be available.
Oh, yeah.
That's our big thing, is just to make sure that everybody can get them when they need them. And Silver Brush Limited is like, yeah, we can handle it.
Mm-hmm.
They came in and they're like, they flew here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And brought brushes. It was the whole thing. I couldn't tell anybody. I was dying. I was dying, dying, dying. Aw, Jane, thank you for the hearts. Oh, Julie says she wish had better art stores. Thank goodness for mail order. I'm telling you, that really helps out. And thank you, Marty, for the congratulations. I really appreciate it so much.
So we're going to be doing this again in the morning, though, right? We're going to be like at noon, back live.
We're going to be back at noon. I may even be testing a triangle brush to see what it does, because I'm curious now. We'll work for brushes. Deb, I do work for brushes. It's just a little hamster wheel of art supplies, brushes, income, art supply, brushes. There's got to be a support group. My husband should probably send me to.
Now, so I'm just making sure we've got all of our things. So
thank you, Lizzie. I love my hair too. And I'm the spice of somebody's life, but the thing went by really fast. I go by and I read the comments. And you know what's lovely is you can actually click all the little emojis and see who sent what emoji.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. It's not anonymous like YouTube, in case you didn't know. There, who's having all those feels unclear on how it all works, how any of it works.
So, yeah, the...
Any good tips for stores in Canada for brushes? Yes, if you are close to a store and you're in Canada, just say, do you carry silver brushes? And if they send them, they say, oh, you should, because I'd really like to get them.
Mm-hmm.
Silver Brush Company Limited. And we're going to be at NAMTA. And they can come by NAMTA and get them right then. Because these are all going to be available right after, right?
Yes, immediately.
Immediately. I want to play with all these, but I have to go to sleep. That's the thing about getting brushes like late, is then you need to sleep. But then you're like, but I need to know what it does. Look at all this. Look, I got daggers here. Look at these daggers. And I have these. This is... the twiggly bit brush.
Mm-hmm.
When you're like, I'm going to twiggly bit these little brushes. What I can never do is get this plastic tube back on those filaments. That's just, you know.
Yeah.
Oh, Sandy, she says she denies the art support group. She's like, if I'm wrong, I don't want to be right. I'm with you, Sandy. I don't want to be right either. I really just need all the art supplies.
Yes.
I need all of them. Even if I'm not currently doing that particular medium, sometimes I want those supplies, right? Just in case. Just in case something comes up and I need to do encaustic. I need to have the wax here. Just, you know, for an art emergency like you have.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you, Ashley. What color reds on the Steampunk Girl? Those are listed in the description on the thing, but I believe it's Cad Red Light and Naphthol. So it's a cool and a warm red. So any cool and warm red will work. And we'll talk about that a bit tomorrow. And I hope you guys are good. We're going to be kind of bopping in and out this whole week before we go to the show.
Yep.
And showing you things and working with things. I'm going to be demoing some of these in some of these lives, where I'm going to talk about like how they work and what we're doing.
Mm-hmm.
That should be fun too. And why I thought they were cool, because I've been, you know, you might have noticed I've been low-key messing with them.
Yeah.
Trying to be like, I'll call them like... like, I would really love something, but I couldn't be like, oh my gosh, I love it so much. But I did. Jackie wants to know if there's going to be a limit of how many will be sold.
No. No?
No, definitely didn't want that.
No, there's
a limit.
There's as far
Silver
as I know.
Brush said no limit. That no, they're good.
We're gonna like is if you yeah. There's they can keep up with supply. So
and they we'll be, swore.
And we're gonna try to get a lot more of this up this week mm-hmm. too. So we're gonna keep updating the frequently asked questions. Keep trying to get more of that stuff up there for you guys.
Oh, look, Deborah says she's in Michigan. She's close to Michael's.
Oh,
so I guess let's all you know again. Whoever your local distributor is, no matter if they're national or local,
yep.
Just let them know and be like, I really need this here. Because wouldn't that just be nice? I'd like to be able to go in and get whatever I need. Well, actually, no, I can't because these boxes come. So I'm set. But we need you guys to be set. That's really key is I'm set now. And I have a nice little brush hoard that I ferret on. Like Smaug the dragon over through my little brushes. But, you know.
So tomorrow, what time?
Tomorrow noon? At noon.
At noon.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And you can find out more about this and all of our other stuff at TheArtSherpa.com.
TheArtSherpa.com.
Which I'll put it down because it's all weird shaped.
Yes.
And, oh gosh, it's so late. My brain is like going
Thank
away.
Thank you all for being here for
Thank
this.
You for hanging I out on our late
drawing,
night.
I hope the drawing helped. And, you know, well, hopefully that'll work out really well for everybody.
Yeah. I think so. We love you guys.
Love
I
you.
Think this is. I think we're.
Dreams of crayons and colors and your favorite color and all your favorite things. And I hope whatever's worrying you, you're able to leave that behind and just have a restful sleep so we can paint together tomorrow, rested and restored.
Yes.
And I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye-bye. Good night.